Hello, and welcome to the April land market update. Well, there's no doubt about it, GB finished land prices are still running well above year-earlier levels, and this is despite all the uncertainty we've had around trading with the EU. Easter is only a few days away, and so it falls before the end of step one in the government's plans to open up the economy. But with all that in mind, what's behind the strength in the market? Well, I think we really have to put it down to the supply side. More of last year's lamb crop was killed last year. Around 270,000 more clean sheep were slaughtered between June and December than in the same months in 2019. And that was from a similar or even slightly smaller lamb crop too. So that means we almost certainly have fewer lambs on the ground now. In the UK, sheep meat production in January and February was 7,000 tonnes lower than a year ago. There were lower exports from New Zealand to Europe and the UK in January and February as well, getting on towards 10,000 tonnes less than a year ago. All this has tightened the supply situation even further now and in the coming weeks. So that's the supply side. What about demand? We know that demand in general has done a pretty good job at moving from out of the home into retail sales during the coronavirus pandemic. But we can't ignore the fact that demand at Easter itself could be relatively subdued again. After that, the forecast for demand depends on how we come out of lockdown and how confident people feel about eating out again. Our base case forecast is that demand overall will be a little lower year on year in 2021 by around 3%. Sheep meat prices are higher than a lot of buyers are used to paying, both here and abroad, and the effect that could have on demand can't be ignored either. Prices in France, our main export market, have been falling recently, and if that continues, it could be a signal of weaker demand. Talking about trade, data from HMRC points to both lower import volumes and lower export volumes in January. Some of this decline would have been planned, as traders prepared for leaving the EU late last year. But some of it was unplanned, as traders wrestled with the new processes that trading with the EU now brings. Although having said that, French data records sheep meat imports from the UK as being higher in January, so it might take a little while before we get a clearer picture. Of course, Paris itself has gone into a month-long lockdown again. So, in summary, tighter supplies, yes, but questions about future demand remain. That's all we have time for, I'm afraid. But for the latest analysis on the UK sheep market, you can always visit the AHDB website, or why not subscribe to Cattle and Sheep Weekly to receive news and views in your inbox every Friday.